when it comes to sites in Rome, the list usually includes the Vatican, the Colosseum, and of course, the world-famous Trevi Fountain.
Everybody in the world knows Fontana di Trevi. It's marvelous.
Thousands visit the fountain every day, and each one of them comes prepared with at least one coin.
Throwing one coin into the Trevi Fountain, you are guaranteed to return to Rome. Throwing a second coin into the Trevi Fountain, alongside the first, you are guaranteed to fall in love with a Roman. And throwing even a third, you will eventually be married to a local, to a Roman.
Eventually, the coins add up to thousands of euros. The city collects the money and gives it to local charities on a regular basis. But what's the actual history behind the fountain? Well, in Roman times, it was an aqueduct point. In the Middle Ages, it was damaged during invasions. Several designers and popes played a role in making the fountain a reality. But the 1700s were key. That's when Pope Clement XII held a competition to see who could best rebuild the fountain. The winner was Nicola Salvi, who was inspired by the sketches Bernini left behind. Under the rule of monarchs, only perfection was acceptable.
Back in those days, you make a mistake, you'll pay a load. A load may also be your life. Evidently, in the times of the constructions of the Trevi Fountain, they probably wouldn't have killed you for an insuccess, but they definitely would have put you completely out of business, and you would have had to move on entirely to some other aspect.
The fountain was inaugurated in 1743 under Pope Benedict XIV. Like most sites in Rome, religion played a key role.
The funny thing is how they actually managed to mingle both the Christian as well as the pagan faith. Christian, the men eventually paying for it, coming up for it, eventually also ideating it. On the other hand, yet the pagans with the actual pieces that are on display, as most of those figures, actually if not all of those figures, happen to be pagan gods or pagan figures.
Fresh water passed through the aqueducts for years, until 2007 when a line was damaged during construction. Now the recycled water is changed every 2 weeks.
It's wonderful.
And now thousands of people, in a way, become part of the fountain's history, one coin at a time.